of Delhi University. I wanted to talk about blogging and tips of being a blogger, successful one. So I have presented a PPT and I hope to enlighten everybody with that. So let me share it. So here it is, how to become a blogger and tips for blogging. So first of all, when we talk about blogging and bloggers, so in that online scenario, what comes to our mind is, who is a blogger? So let me tell you, a blogger or a blogster who is a contributor to a blog, online journal, or a website. Bloggers connect with like-minded people via blogs. Now, when I'm talking about blogs, the second thing which will come to our mind is, what are blogs? So, what is a blog? Originally created from the world from the word weblog. A blog is a collection of thoughts, ideas, and experiences stacked up at one place called the internet. It is a popular medium of expression where a person writes regularly about topics that interest them, usually with photographs and links to other websites they find interesting. So there is a drastic difference between vlogger and a blogger. A vlog is a video content, whereas a blog is a written content. The videos we see on Instagram are vlogs, whereas the articles we read on WordPress are blogs. The person who makes vlog is called vlogger, and who writes content for the website or a blog is called blogger. We need to understand this, as this is a very major confusion which we see in people. There is also a big difference between blogging and traditional websites. Blogs are updated frequently, whereas websites have largely evergreen content. Whenever we search something on the internet, we can see it that what we search today and obtain the result, we will obtain the same result when we do that same search after 10 to 15 years. But blogs, we will find them updated. We'll find all the recent activities and data updated on our blog. So blogs also allow for reader engagement, whereas websites have only one-way communication. As I already told you in the first slide, that blogs connect like-minded people. So we can also communicate via blogs, but when we see the traditional websites, we can only read the content and we can only apply it. We cannot cross-question it, neither can we talk on it to someone. So there are pros and cons of everything. So there are pros and cons of blogging too. Pros of blogging: it's flexible and portable. That means we can literally do blogging from anywhere at any time with absolutely nothing, just our laptop and internet connection, and also with ideas. Second pro of blogging is it keeps clients up to date. As we discussed that the traditional websites do not get their data updated, and blogs definitely update their data. So pros of blogging includes keeping clients up to date. Third point is helps build trust with customers. When we can communicate with like-minded people and share our ideas with them, that in that way we can also build trust with our customers. Blogs can also make money. According to our engagement rate, we can also make money via blogs. Then there are cons of blogging. Blogging requires a lot of time. We need to research a lot. We need to update our daily data. We need to build confidence in our customers. That requires a lot of time. It needs new content often, as we need to update it every now and then whenever anything new happens. So we require a lot of time. And then we also need new content very often. Payoff is not immediate. It mostly takes around 1 month to earn, to receive what, according to our engagement rate, to receive the amount of money which we can make from a blog. then how to start blogging. Many people think that I want to be a blogger, I can be a blogger, but they don't know from where to exactly start. So first of all, you or anyone should feel like a blogger, because when you feel like a blogger, then only you'll think that you are ready to become a blogger, you're ready to start doing blogging. So make sure you are ready and set up your blog. Now, people do not understand what it means by setting up your own blog. So here it is. There are free blog options such as WordPress and Blogger. But to retain control and a professional image, we can consider investing in a domain name and a hosting service. It will require a little bit of investment if we want to control the whole website by ourselves. Otherwise, if we do not want to do that, there are also free blog options such as WordPress and Blogger. One can install WordPress or another content management system on their host if they don't want to create the whole site from scratch. Once the blog is up and running, we need to keep it active with new content to grow our business. Develop a set of schedule for writing and posting blog articles. We need to be very frequent in order to avoid losing customers. Create a content calendar so we always know what we're going to post. This is a very good habit in those who want to keep their blog updated and attractive and to maintain their customers and to earn frequent money. Then we also need to focus on market, what our customer wants from us. So, like all other business ideas, once success comes from marketing and getting their message in front of their target market. Great ways to reach market are through social media apps, email lists, and by reaching out to other bloggers, podcasters, and media outlets for publicity. Repurpose your blog content to promote our business across platforms, such as by using quotes on our Twitter or Instagram profiles, or by creating a video of our article to share on YouTube. It basically means we need to know what our target customers want, and accordingly, we need to create our content, and then we need to increase our reach through email IDs, Instagram, and other social media platforms. Then we can also add income streams. While our blog can complement an existing business, it's also a great way to add additional income streams to our home business. We can promote other companies' products and services in affiliate marketing. We can also advertise or feed ad networks onto our own blog. If we have a service business we're promoting with our blog, we can create our own information products to complement it. Or if we have our own product, we can offer a service. It means we can do anything on our blog. Either we can promote somebody else's product, or if we have our own product line, we can also write about it and promote it. Then modern blogging. What is modern blogging? Modern blogging is an expansive medium that incorporates written words, photography, videos, and all kinds of subject matters. Businesses can use blogs to drive customers to their website, increase SEO, which is search engine optimization performance, or generate alternate streams of income. We need to make our blog attractive. Unlike those traditional blogging websites, we need to add photographs, videos, and all kinds of subject matters which make our blog attractive. All bloggers have one thing in common. They want their blog to succeed. For most bloggers, success means converting loyal followers. Who does not want success? So, in order to help one succeed his or her blog, he needs to check his conversion rate. His conversion rate means the number of customers he can make. There are a lot of people who land on our blog but do not engage with it. So we need more of engagement so that we can convert loyal followers and make money. So here are some tips for blogging. Find a niche. Niche is a specialized but profitable corner of the market. What readers really want is a collection of related and helpful articles on the same topic to help solve a problem or question. Examples of niches are parenting, finance, beauty, fitness, web design, home decor, etc. The thing which interests us the most is the thing which we will be able to do in the best way. So it's really important for one, if he or she wants to start a blog, he or she first find his or her own niche. Then we should indulge in self-promotion. It's a part of the marketing process and it's totally normal. And bloggers have to learn how to use social media and blog commenting functions to market themselves. Many bloggers and social media enthusiasts suggest using 80% of your social comments and shares to promote other people's works and 20% of it promoting your own products and services. Then you should also you should also try to make people return to or stay at your blog. It is what sticky means here. Make your blog sticky. For this, you can link a relevant article from your blog's archives. There are people who land on your blog, just as I said earlier, but do not engage with your blog or your web journal. But you have to make it sticky. In order to make it sticky, we can do various things. We can also attach links from various relevant articles in case of providing proofs to our articles, or we can also provide our previous blog's links in that article in order for the person to click to that link and land on the previous article of ours, and that's how we can make our blog sticky. The idea is that these links point to your own content and offer readers more in-depth information on the topic or a related subject. As you do this, people are more likely to stick around and subscribe to your blog. Build on what works. We do not need to experiment all the time. We have to experiment once or twice. Once we find what interests people the most, we need to build on that. That's why we say use your website statistics and commenting functions to see how readers react to these new ideas. If you're not seeing any indication of a reaction in your stats, poll your readers to see what they think. Then you'll definitely get to know what they think, whether your article or whether your new niche which you are experimenting on is good or bad, what the readers think about it, because all you have to do is engage your readers and convert them into loyal followers. Then at last, ditch the ones that do not work. You must not continue, you must not build your blog on what is not working. Then, of course, you have to create quality content. Content is the king in the field of blogging. Without engaging and well-written content, your blog won't get any reach. People might land at your blog because of your marketing, but they will only stay there if your content is good enough. You need to see what your target audience is looking for and create according to that. Thank you.